Here we are in Relief Maker, and we're going to talk about the right way to choose the correct image format to send outputs to your other programs. Here we are, and we have a scene made of a bunch of different mushrooms that we've imported. We've arranged them in a nice way. Let's go ahead and make a relief. And we'll just inspect it. We're saying this looks good. And so now we're ready to export. So the first thing you need to know is that each software program out there in the world is going to interpret height maps in one of basically two ways. It's going to expect a linear encoding of the height data, or it's going to expect a gamma encoding of the height data. When you look at linear versus gamma encodings on the outputs, you're not going to visually be able to see much of a difference. So it's important to test which one your program expects. And we've built in a way to do that. So let's just get started. Let's go to File, Export Relief. We'll call this Mushrooms, and we're gonna choose the 16-bit height map. Don't worry about any of the other formats. You'll know if you need to use them, if you're an advanced user. But for now, everything will open a 16-bit height map. So just choose that and press Save. Now we get this dialog come up, and it tells us, hey, you need to pick if you want the linear encoding or the gamma encoding. And you're not going to know which one to choose. And so instead of guessing, just test it, right? Because you only need to test it once per software that you're using. So we're going to export the gamma test height map. We'll call it gamma test and press save. So now we're going to jump into whatever other software we're going to be using. It could be CAM software, it could be sculpting software, it could be Blender. And in our case, we're going to try it on two different ones. So here we are in Mesh CAM. Let's go ahead and load that test image that was automatically created for us. Maybe two, it doesn't really matter how tall we make it. And so what we're looking for here is one of the two sides is going to be a straight ramp and one of them is going to be curved. And we want to find which one is straight. So in our case, in this example, for this software, linear is straight and gamma is curved. So we want to make sure that we export using the linear option for Mesh CAM. So here we are in Blender, just to show another example, and we've done kind of the same workflow. We've imported this test image and used it as a displacement map. And unlike Mesh CAM, where linear was the side that was straight, in our case, Blender interprets the gamma as the default, such that it is the straight ramp. And Blender and probably every software offers additional options. So I could actually interpret this as linear. And you'll notice if we do that, all of a sudden the linear side becomes the straight side, right? So depending on the complexity of your software that you have available, you may be able to choose these. But just be aware that by default, Blender, for example, wants the gamma, right? Whereas Mesh CAM wants the linear. So now that we know that, let's say we're going into Mesh CAM. We know that Mesh CAM wants a linear output, so we're going to choose linear. We'll press OK. And now let's go ahead and open this in Mesh CAM. We'll just click Load, Mushrooms, Open. And maybe give it a height of 0.5 inches. And there we go. Looks great. If we were going to bring this into Blender, which we know wants a gamma, we go back, Export Relief, call it Mushrooms Gamma, save that and choose Gamma. We'll press OK. Now if we jump back into Blender, we can replace this test image with the Gamma and then go back to our displacement modifier and turn the strength way down. And we'd have to play with it a little bit, but we get a very similar result, right? So if you choose the wrong one, what's gonna happen is your sidewalls are gonna get really distorted and it's just not gonna look good. It'll look similar, but it's not gonna be what you want. So the big takeaway here is do a quick test in whatever software you're using, figure out what it wants, and then export that. That's simple.